Good evening and welcome to tonight's concert, both here and for those of you online, welcome. For those of you online, if you go to the description in YouTube, you'll see a download of the program, and you can download the program so you have that. So happy that you could join us. We've got a great selection of music we'd like to perform for you. Of course, opening with Don Hunsberger's arrangement of Shostakovich's Festive Overture. So we've titled the concert Festive Overture because it's a festive time tonight. We're going to go on with a piece by John Mackey called Sheltering Sky.
Thank you.
I love the music of Percy Grainger. He did a lot of his compositions based on folk tunes of England and Ireland. Molly on the Shore is a little bit of a theme and variations, if you will. What he likes to do is give so many different musical textures, and all of a sudden you'll hear something come screaming out of the melody, and then he'll use a great deal of dynamics. So we'd like to do a performance of Percy Grainger's Molly on the Shore. Thank you. setting up for this next piece. For those especially that don't have the program, let me tell you about this next work. It's called Steampunk Scenes. And Erika writes about steampunk. It refers to a subgenre of science fiction and sometimes fantasy that incorporates technology and aesthetic designs inspired by 19th century industrial steam-powered machinery. It places places an emphasis on steam or spring-propelled gadgets. The most common historical steampunk settings are often set in the Victorian era, but in an alternative history where technology employs steam power. It may therefore be described as a neo-Victorian. Steampunk features retro-futuristic inventions as people in the 19th century might have envisioned them, and it is likewise rooted in the era's perspective on fashion, culture, architectural style, and art. Such technology may include fictional machines like those found in the works of H.G. Wells and Jules Verne. Steampunk Scenes attempts to depict various scenes that take place in a fictional alternate history that features notable people alive in the Victorian era, including Charles Ives, Marie Curie, H.G. Wells, Jules Verne, P.T. Barnum, and Nikola Tesla. It borrows from a popular music of the era, including the Cakewalk March, Waltz, and the song Daisy Bell. These are combined with sounds of clockwork and imagined steam technology. It also borrows various musical elements from numerous composers of the time, including Ives, Sousa, Satie, Carl King, Stravinsky, and Weill, and some Khachaturian and Danny Elfman thrown in for good measure. The first movement is Charlie and the Mechanical Man Marching Band. And in this movement, you know, as all machines, they start off okay, but then you're gonna start to hear some quirks in the machine and eventually it breaks down a little bit, but then it gets going again. And the rest of the movements are pretty self-explanatory. But if you start to hear the machine falter, it's meant to be. So enjoy Steampunk Scenes. We're gonna take a quick tune and then we'll go right at it. Thank you. have some good news and some bad news. The good news is we have a really good trumpet section. The bad news is they're all leaving after this year and graduating. So we thought we better feature them. And of course, everybody knows like Bugler's Holiday, Interpreter's Lullaby, and all of that stuff. But here's a great piece by Albert Oliver Davis that's been around for quite a while, but it's new to me. And now it's just out and published, called Cascading Trumpets. So we're going to feature our trumpet section on this piece. Hope you enjoy. Oh, the time goes by so fast when you're having fun. I hope you've enjoyed this concert and enjoyed the selections. It's been a lot of fun to put it together. We're going to end with one more piece giving tribute to trumpet players. This one is giving tribute to Louis Armstrong, who influenced so many players, not only trumpet players, but other jazz musicians throughout history. And so we're going to do a little medley of tunes that he made famous, including What a Wonderful World, When the Saints Go Marching In, St. Louis Blues, and Hello, Dolly. So I hope you enjoy this. Thank you so much again for coming tonight, and we'll do this again next month, and we'll see you then. But for now, here's Satchmo.